like to call the Budget Committee meeting to order, please. 1.1 Fire Safety Plan, I ask the chief to review that, please.
Through the chair, just a reminder that this building is equipped with a single stage alarm system. Unlike the event of a fire emergency, the alarm will sound and all of us will immediately calmly exit the building. Make your way up through the central staircase behind me. We'll meet at the Service Ontario building. There are alternate exits at the rear of the gallery as well as across the adjoining committee room. A fire extinguisher is located immediately out in the hallway behind me as well as the elevator. However, the elevator cannot be used in an emergency. So if you are a person requiring assistance, remain at the top of the stairs where emergency responders will make their way to your location. And just a reminder that there is a defibrillator located on the lower level in the hallway by the water fountain.
Thank you. Disclosure of pecuniary interest and nature thereof. Seeing none. There are no delegations. Correspondence. D. Kilburn, CIBC Investment Counselor, read 2019 Q3 Investment Report. Recommend receipt for information. May I have a mover and a seconder for that? Moved by Deputy Mayor, seconded by Councillor Lees. Any questions? All in favor? That's good. No business from previous minutes. New business, 5.1. S. Brown, Tax and Revenue Manager, write-off, cancellation, reduction, and refund of taxes. Section 357.1 and 358.1 of the Municipal Act 2001. SO 2001 C25. Recommend that Budget Committee approve the attached Schedule B, write-off, cancellation, reduction, and refund of taxes, estimated in the amount of $36,377, in accordance with Sections 357.1 and 358.1 of the Municipal Act 2001, SO 2001 C25. As amended, and pursuant to Section 357.5A, any applicant in attendance may address the committee regarding their application. And may I have a mover and a seconder for this? Moved by Deputy Mayor, seconded by Councillor Bittle. Any questions or comments? Deputy Mayor?
Will we be receiving the county and the education portion back in the revenue?
Through the chair, yes, we do receive it back.
Any other questions? All in favor? That's carried. 5.2, Gabe Goodrich, Finance Manager, S. Brown, Tax and Revenue Manager, and S. Crooks, Procurement and Payables Administrator, read 2019 Third Quarter Q3 Financial Report. Recommend receipt for information. May I have a mover and a seconder, please? Moved by Councillor Mink, seconded by Councillor Meadows. Is there any comments or questions? All in favor? And that's good. 5.3, Jay Davidson, Director of Works and Engineering, Re-Ganaraska Region Conservation Authority 2020 Preliminary Budget. Recommend that Budget Committee support the Ganaraska Region Conservation Authority 2020 Preliminary Budget and refer the proposed budget to 2020 budget deliberations, and further, that Budget Committee identify any feedback to be provided to the GRCA. And may I have a mover and a seconder for that? Moved by Councillor Meadows, seconded by Councillor Mink. Any questions or comments? Deputy Mayor.
Yeah, I'm pleased with the overall cost, but the general levy has jumped by $31,000. Is there any explanation to why they jumped it so high?
Director Director Davidson, can you speak to that?
Through the chair, so the general levy now includes the asset management component that was identified separately in the 2019 budget. So it's now just as one item instead of two.
But it was still 169 in 2019 and 197.
Right, and the asset management planning component was 25,000 in addition to the 169.
Was that identified last year?
Yes.
As an additional?
Now they've been combined as one item.
And so it's the increase isn't that severe after all?
That's correct.
Thank you.
Any other comments, questions? All in favor? And that's carried. 5.4, Jay McCormick, Director of Parks, Recreation and Culture, and Beth Beattie, Parks and Facilities Manager, Lighting Replacement. Recommend that a resolution be prepared for presentation to Council on November 19th, 2019 to allocate insurance funds received for the fallen light standard at the Town Agricultural Park in the amount of $39,277.55 in order to complete the removal of the remaining original Southwest light standard at the Town Agricultural Park and to replace various light fixtures with LED lighting at the Jack Berger Sports Complex at an amount not to exceed $39,277.55. May I have a mover and a seconder, please? Councillor Meadows and Councillor Lees. Any questions, comments? I would just like to say that I thought that was a really really well used and a really good way to accommodate having that insurance money come back and use it in the way that it was. So, well done. Any other comments? All in favor? Ms. Carey? 5.5, C. Ryan Aker, Director of Fire and Emergency Services, Comprehensive Downtown Parking Study Update. Recommend that a resolution be prepared for presentation to Council to authorize staff to engage with IBI Group to prepare an updated comprehensive downtown parking study. The total estimated cost of the updated study would be approximately $25,440, with provisional options in the approximate amount of $15,468. To complete a financial model, prepare a list of suitable available technology solutions, complete a review of the municipality's current parking fines, and design considerations for lighting, signage, landscaping, and pedestrian lamps. May I have a mover and a seconder, please? Moved by Deputy Mayor, seconded by Councillor Lees. Any questions or comments? Councillor Lees?
I know I've been on council for a long time, but the last study we did, this not us but as a council, but we paid about the same kind of money, sat on the shelf, and we didn't implement probably a third of what was in that study at the time. And again, I feel, you know, another consultant, this council and the previous council wanted to get away from consultants. We have a lot of expertise in our municipality with staff. Our bylaw enforcement people, we have a lot of people that could come forward for a lot less money, I think $25,000, to hire another consultant to tell us the basics that could get us through for the next 3 or 4 years. Nothing's changed really dramatically in the downtown core. We don't have a lot of extra parking, we all know that, but there is some possibilities that I don't think would cost $25,000, and I'm not in favor of spending $25,000 to come forward to do another consultation and another consultant's review to sit on a shelf and do nothing again for the next 4 years of our term. So I think it's a total waste of money. We have the expertise within to do some recommendations that we could do affordably and sensibly that won't cost us $25,000. I think we have the staff to do that here. We really don't need to spend the $25,000 on another consultant. So that's just my opinion.
Thank you, Councillor Lease. And I must say that I feel basically the same way. I would like to have an opportunity to review the one that was done in 2010 and see what, if anything, has been implemented from that. And for the things that haven't been implemented, why have they not been implemented? So that we can have an understanding of that before we go and spend another $40,000 if we do the full package. Deputy Mayor?
I disagree with both of you, and I don't think we have the staff resources to do a comprehensive study. I don't know what the last study looked like. I don't know why it was, why some things weren't implemented. I always equate, if you have a study and you don't have the resources to implement it, that could be a problem. And I see this as a very comprehensive thing. We don't have the expertise on staff to tell us how to implement ticketless or moneyless parking and e-based solutions to filling the coin meter up when you're at the Capitol Theater. We just don't have those resources. And if we left it up to our own people to do it, the time frame would extend. Now we've got severe pressures from the residents on Walton Street, both the downtown business owners and those people that live about the apartments that have no place to park, but there just isn't any place, and are desperately crying for permit parking. You know, these people are getting $250 tickets a month, and they just don't, there is no scapegoat for them, no place for them to go. So I think we should get the study done, whether it's a consultant or expert or whatever you want to call this. It's somebody that brings expertise that we do not have on site to get this thing completed and, you know, have a commitment from staff to implement what we have. The current bylaw, parking bylaw, runs to about 78 pages. And one, I don't know if anybody that can make any sense of it. Every parking space is identified and some conditions and counter conditions against every parking space in town, and it's just a whole bunch of nothing about nothing. The document is obsolete, it should be shredded, and we should bring ourselves into the 21st century.
I'm in favor with you. I think it's too much money for us to spend on something that's already been done once. I know, Deputy Mayor, you just said you weren't familiar with the document, and yet you want it to be shredded. I think it'd be probably wise to look at it, and I agree with you, Mark. Thank you very much. Councillor Rook?
Well, I do agree with some of the things that the Deputy Mayor has said. I haven't seen the original study, so before actually seeing it, I can't make that decision. So at minimum, I think this request should be deferred until we have a chance to review that, to evaluate whether this cost is validated. Maybe it's not included in that study, what's being proposed now, but I don't know that, so I can't speak to that or vote on that at this time. I don't feel comfortable. So unless I see something different that's being proposed now as to what came out 4 years ago or however long ago it was, I can't make that decision. I don't feel confident with that.
I wasn't alluding to the study to be shredded. I was alluding to our bylaws to be shredded because they make no sense.
My apology.
Apology accepted.
Any other questions, comments? All in favor? Oh, sorry?
Yeah. I would support Councillor Mink in dusting off the old study and having a look at it and revisiting this topic at a future council meeting. I just don't want to drop the momentum that we have right now and just abandon it, because I don't think anything will be done if we do that. So I would support Councillor Macon bringing this back.
So we'll vote on that.
Sure. So I would like to make a motion that we defer this back to staff to provide us with the previous study and any other relevant information to support this request.
So on the first motion, which is on the table, which is to authorize it, may I have a show of hands for all in favor?
Sorry, Madam Chair. The last motion received to refer this back to staff takes precedence over the main motion. So. If that vote is carried, to refer this back to staff for a review of the previous study and any other additional information is required, it'll be referred back to staff. The main motion just sort of falls off.
So we have a mover and a seconder for that. Councillor Lees?
Is that also, could we get staff to show us what we've implemented and what we haven't implemented in the old study? Because it's been around for a long time, and I know there was bits and pieces implemented and a lot wasn't. We also have staff to identify which pieces in the whole study have been implemented. That would be really great if you could.
Yes.
Yeah. Okay, and on that motion, all in favor? And that's carried. Any other business anybody has to bring up? Any questions? Seeing none. Future budget committee meetings are recorded here as Monday, December 2nd and Wednesday, December 4th. I would like to request that they be put off to Monday, December 9th and Wednesday, December 11th. Because I will not be able to be here on the 2nd and the 4th because of surgery. So if I could request that indulgence from the committee that the dates be changed, that would be understood. And with that, budget committee is adjourned.